Every day I see so many people posting photos of armpit rashes that they got from deodorants or antiperspirants, and this keeps happening. What is it that they're putting in these deodorants and these antiperspirants that's causing these rashes? So my name is Kasper Kubica. I'm the co-founder of Carpe, which makes sweat stopping products for all over the body. And I've been studying deodorants and the science of sweat for about 7 years now. So I'm not a doctor, this is not medical advice, but I study this a lot and I'm excited to talk about it. In this video, we're going to cover why deodorant rashes are so common, what types of deodorant rashes there are, what most often causes these, and what you can do about it. So it turns out that deodorants and antiperspirants are among the most common cosmetics to cause rashes, to give any sort of irritation or reaction. There's basically two reasons for this. One is that the skin in your armpits is uniquely sensitive and soft and thin. And the second is that it's occluded, meaning that whatever you put there kind of gets trapped there by your armpit all day. So this means that even if you're using something that wouldn't give you a reaction on another part of your body that's maybe more exposed, underarm skin is uniquely predisposed to really suss out any allergies or irritations that you may have to a particular ingredient. Maybe you're allergic to eucalyptus oil and you've used a eucalyptus shampoo for a while and you've never had a reaction. Now you use a deodorant with eucalyptus oil and you have a rash. That makes perfect sense, right? Because with the shampoo, you're washing it off, it's not sticking around. With the armpit deodorant or antiperspirant, it's staying there, it's getting rubbed in, it's occlusive, and that skin is super sensitive. So deodorants, regardless of who you are very likely to be the product that lets you discover you have some kind of skin allergy. There are four types of allergic reaction, commonly agreed. This is kind of debated, like how do you classify allergies? But broadly speaking, you've got irritant contact dermatitis and then four types of allergic contact dermatitis. The two that matter are type 1 and type 4. Type 1, it's a reaction by immunoglobulin E, and that is like that immediate allergic reaction. That's what can cause anaphylactic shock and skin allergy. I don't think that's likely, but it can cause hives in severe cases. So when like a dermatologist or an allergist is testing for a type 1 allergy, they're gonna put something on your skin and then give you like a skin prick. You will develop hives or some kind of reaction at that site within an hour or so, even quicker usually. Types 2 and 3, more complicated, don't really pertain to skin sensitivity as much, but type 4 is a type of allergy regulated by T cells that doesn't present for usually 2 days. You can put on a product, you can wear it one day, be fine, wear it the next day, be fine, and then the third day, you notice, I have a rash now, and that is the type 4 reaction. What are the most common ingredients in these products that could be causing a reaction? The first one is fragrance. This is because fragrance is sort of a free-for-all label on cosmetic and OTC antiperspirant products. That means that while the FDA requires all other ingredients to be listed in a product label, the fragrance label could contain any sort of ingredients, up to 300 oftentimes, literally 300 ingredients in a single fragrance, and you have no idea what they are because they're not required to be listed on the product labeling. And a lot of these are natural essential oils or other things that are common allergens. At the concentration they're used, they don't cause allergies in most people, but everybody's different. And so you may have a particular sensitivity to something in a fragrance. You're not going to see that it's there. You're just going to see fragrance. You'll put the product on, and then 2 days later, you might have a rash. The second thing to watch out for is propylene glycol, I think. This isn't the most common allergen, but it is found in right about half of antiperspirants and deodorants, and it is an allergen. So check for that on the label, see if that's maybe what's causing it. And then the third thing to look out for is another type of fragrance, which is essential oils. Allergies, you might have hay fever, you might be allergic to bee stings, but generally allergies develop in response to things that are natural, that are in the natural world around us. So natural essential oils are actually very commonly the cause of allergic reactions. Often times these essential oils are hidden under that fragrance label, but especially with newer natural products or products that want to say they're fragrance free, they will have that essential oil specifically on the label, or products that just want to be more transparent because fragrance kind of hides a lot of information. They will have their essential oil in the ingredients list. So if you see an essential oil, you may want to see whether that's what's causing the reaction. If you have a sensitivity to a product that has eucalyptus oil, and then you try another product with eucalyptus oil and you put it on your skin for a few days and you have a sensitivity, maybe that's what's causing it. So those are three things to watch out for. I'd say there's basically three steps. If you have an underarm rash, to try to find a product that doesn't cause one. The first step is literally try any different product. So many of these products are so different and the fragrances are so different. It's very likely that once you switch to any other product, you're not going to have that same issue. The second is try a sensitive skin or non-irritating antiperspirant or deodorant, because these massively restrict the family of ingredients that they use to the ones that are very, very unlikely to cause allergies. Almost anything can and does cause an allergy in some people, but the sensitive skin, fragrance-free products generally cause the least amount of allergies. These will often avoid fragrances, or if they use fragrances, they're gonna avoid the most common allergens in fragrances. They're gonna avoid essential oils, and they're probably gonna avoid propylene glycol. The final step, if you're trying all these products, you're trying sensitive skin products, and you still have an armpit rash, definitely go see a dermatologist, go see an allergist, and they will be able to help you figure out what may be causing that irritation. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something from it. Check out Carpe, check out our other videos, and please let us know in the comments what other questions you'd love for us to answer.